Hey guys, it's John. Welcome back. Today, I'm going to answer a question that I've gotten several times, which is, can you get a good tech job without a college degree? And a variant of this is, can you get a good tech job without a computer science degree? This video is going to answer both of those definitively, going straight to the source from the hiring perspective, as well as real life examples to show you if you need a college degree or not to get that dream job. So let's get started. Let's go straight to the source of some of the most competitive, desirable companies in the world hiring software engineers and see what they have to say about this question. So here we're on Google's website. We're on careers.google.com, how we hire. I mean, straight from the source from Google, do I need a computer science degree to be a Google software engineer? No. A CS degree isn't required for most of our software engineering or product manager roles. All right. As if that wasn't straightforward enough, let's continue. See what Elon has to say. So Tesla is a very cool company doing very hard engineering work, recruiting top talent. And one of the posts that Elon made back in November of 2020 is he was recruiting ace engineers for Giga Berlin. And somebody asked a follow-up question. And Elon says, just looking for problem solvers who get things done with a high sense of urgency, don't care if or where they went to school. Elon's been quoted several times talking about how education doesn't matter. What he cares about is people that can problem solve effectively and who have the skill set necessary to do the job. So those are just two examples from very competitive companies of their perspective on hiring as it relates to a degree. I also pulled up some actual job descriptions that are current. I looked on the career websites for first, Microsoft, and this is just an example role of a software engineer in Redmond in Azure, which is coincidentally where I work. And let's look at the qualifications here. So successful candidate will have 3+ years of experience, Linux, Windows kernel experience. Now, do we see anything here that is requiring a degree? Okay, so once we get to the degree bullet point, it does list either a computer science degree or equivalent experience. So this is generally what you're gonna see. You're either gonna see a qualification or a requirement that a candidate needs to have a degree or that they have equivalent practical experience. And the reason for that is that the degree is just a proxy for the skills necessary for the job. And so if they're able to demonstrate that with practical experience, then a degree is not required. Let's look at some more examples. So let's look at Facebook. So this is a role for a software engineer in connectivity. Minimum qualifications. Talk about experience, talk about fundamentals, design and development of network functions, mobile networks, C++ development skills, debugging, designing test and validation plans, and then they list some preferred qualifications. Nowhere in here on this job description do they list something about a necessary degree or a computer science degree. Okay, so that's two examples. This is another example from Facebook, a software engineer, an Android engineer. Once again, they're just talking about experience for this job, object-oriented software development, experience driving change within an organization, building maintainable and testable code bases, and multi-threaded programming and mobile memory management. If you have those skills, you've met the minimum qualifications of the job. And once again, you do not need a college degree or a computer science degree to apply or get this job. Let's look at some more examples. Stripe, great company. And I did a control find on here. There's not even a mention of education, college, degree, nothing. This is a back-end engineer for financial data. When they're talking about qualifications, they're talking about what you've done and what you know. So have you delivered production systems? Do you write high-quality code? Are you interested in understanding Stripe's complex financial data problems? Enjoy working with a diverse group of people? Even the nice-to-haves don't even mention education. I like that they have this at the bottom. They mention that you're encouraged to apply even if your experience doesn't precisely match the job description. Your skills and passion will stand out and set you apart, etc. So these are just awesome companies that so far none of them have required a degree or a computer science degree. And then lastly, let's look at Google, another obviously popular company that people want to work for. And minimum qualifications, bachelor's degree or equivalent practical experience. And as we saw in the very beginning, Google explicitly does not require college degrees for most of their engineering roles. Now, some roles you will need a degree. So I'm pretty sure that there are some machine learning and AI roles that require PhD candidates. And that's because some of the nature of the work requires a skill set that I think you pretty much only get in a university. It's hard to demonstrate that from practical experience without a degree, but that is less common increasingly. And most of the examples, as you can see, you can work for some of the top companies in the world. These are like companies that are hard to get hired at. These are considered elite, although you can argue that some of them are waning, some of them are waxing. But regardless, you've seen that like some of the companies that everybody wants to get into and work for, you can get a job without a degree. You can get a job at these companies, and then you can also get a job at a ton of other smaller to mid-sized companies as well. So this requirement of a degree is increasingly unnecessary and going away in the tech industry. Just to drive this point home, let's look at some personal examples. A simple Google search, there's probably dozens of these videos of how I got into Google without a college degree, got my dream job at Google without a degree at the age of 18. That's pretty cool. So as you can see, this is very clearly not a requirement to get a great job in the tech industry. I don't have a computer science degree. I do have a college degree and I work at a big tech company. From all that you've seen, straight from the hiring sources and the real life examples, it's very clear that this question is a resounding no. You do not need a college degree and you do not need a computer science degree to get a good software engineering role at a competitive tech company. Now, with that being said, you don't need a degree, but in which situation would you get one? Personally, if I were talking to a friend or a sibling or a family member and they were asking me this question, I think personally, this is just my opinion, the only reason I would recommend getting a degree is if you are right out of high school, maybe you're like, you know, either from the ages of like 18 to 20 or something. And I would say that, you know, you do get a lot of good foundational knowledge about computer science from a computer science degree that is more difficult to get on your own in an unstructured learning environment. And even coding boot camps aren't as heavy into the computer science aspect of things. So at my current role, there's a lot of like foundational, you know, computer science topics, algorithms, memory management, like operating system stuff that you don't learn in a coding boot camp. So if you're going deep into the weeds of like a back-end engineering role, you might want to consider a degree if you're very young, you have the time and the money, and you just want to do it. But even that being said, you don't have to do it. I spoke with somebody that works at Amazon who doesn't have a high school diploma. I know this person personally. They work at Amazon, and he was telling me that basically he worked at a startup before that for about a year, and in none of his interviews did he remember them ever bringing up college at all. And so it really is, his argument was he built up his brand, and he would recommend that if you had an option between going to college, which he just didn't have time for, he had a family, and many people don't have the luxury of going back to college, he would recommend just building your brand and networking and building your skill set, most importantly. And that's what I would say. I would say, if you don't have a degree, you can get a job, but it's gonna be hard work, just as if you did get a degree. So it's not any less difficult. In fact, it's probably more difficult without a college degree. You are at, I think, often still at a disadvantage in people's perceptions of you. So you have to kind of prove yourself a little bit more. I'm not speaking for my company or any other company, but I do know that this bias sometimes does exist against people without typical computer science degrees, even though it's not a requirement. So you're gonna have to work really hard. You're gonna have to study and fill in the gaps for the role that you're applying to. And as long as you're willing to put in the work to build the skills and the experience and really master the craft, as well as all of the things like building your brand, so contributing in public, whether it's open source or teaching, and definitely networking as well is very important. So connecting with engineers, getting a feel for, you know, the industry, the engineers that work in the industry, building those connections so that way you can find an in to one of these companies without cold applying. So I hope this answers the question. If you're thinking of switching careers into the tech industry or just entering for your first job into the tech industry and you don't have a college degree, you can't afford the time or the money to go get one, I hope this will encourage you that you do not need one. And it is completely optional and you can definitely get a very competitive, high growth, high compensation tech job that will launch your tech career without a degree, which I find very encouraging. And I wish that more people realize this so that way they can begin building the skills necessary to get their dream job. So I hope that helps. If you have any other questions about this or other things related to software engineering, whether it's careers, technical computer science topics for non-CS grads, I would love to answer them. Either mention them in the comments or you can email me personally at johns@hay.com. And if you've listened this far, I would really appreciate it if you could subscribe. It really helps me grow the channel and get more visibility to spread information that I think is helpful. So that being said, I'll see you next time. See ya. Bye.